So many people getting help, direct help, because of those who are getting involved in the New Life Evangelistic Center's Veterans Coming Home Center in Springfield, Missouri. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. I'm in Springfield, Missouri at our Veterans Coming Home Center. Tell us your name.
Shane Poe.
And Shane, how's the place been helping you here?
It helps me a tremendous. I got off the streets a while back, and it helped me with my health and all the amenities I need for like toiletry items and everything, clean clothes, and get on the computers to work, look for jobs and everything.
It's helping to break the cycle of homelessness for people all over Springfield. Let's hear from some of them.
Hi, my name is Tommy Lee. I just really, really appreciate what the Larry Rice program has done for me. I've been homeless for about almost 8 years now, and it's been a constant struggle. I've been sleeping under bridges. I've been sleeping in abandoned buildings and so on and so to speak. But for all of you, all your donations and everything that people have sent us, God bless every single one of you guys for all the help that you guys have contributed towards us. And just God bless you to Larry Rice, too. And the facility here in Springfield, we're able to take a shower, clean ourselves off, brush our teeth. They have openings of different hygiene stuff. We even have a rest area over here, and we have computers to be able to get on to fill out applications and so on and so to speak. And I just really thank you guys for this facility, and God bless you guys.
My name is Amanda Brooks. I've been homeless for about 2 months, and this place is helping me with the sleeping bag, and keep sending your donations in to help the place.
Hello, my name is Charles Ross. I've been homeless since January 2015. Recently relocated to Springfield, and the center has been a beautiful help to me, helped guide me in directions that I needed to go, made me some good contacts. What this sleeping bag will do will help keep me warm and help me survive this winter. Hopefully I can get a job before then, but this will help out. And I ask that you please help donate and continue to donate to the VA, as they are doing wonderful things for this community. Thank you.
My name is Melinda Blakey. I've been homeless for 7 years. I've been coming to the VA since they opened. I've gotten a lot of help from them, being able to take showers, get clothes, get sleeping bags, people bringing in food, just numerous things. Now that winter's coming, being able to get out of the cold after being outside all night and everything, it's a blessing to be able to come in and warm up, have coffee. Donations are really needed here. There's more and more people that are needing it now that winter's here. Blankets and everything, coats and shoes, boots and stuff are needed. So that would be a big help. I'm just thankful for this place. It's done a lot for me.
I've been on the streets off and on since I was 14.
My name is Rosanna Burrell. I have been homeless for a month, and the VA has helped me out with clothes and food, and it's a good place for homeless to go to.
Good morning. I appreciate the VA staff and the VA home center. It's great to come somewhere when you don't have a home. I appreciate the volunteers that bring the food, and it's just really great coming to the VA.
This place needs donations for anything.
Hi, my name is Misty Reifenberg. I've been homeless for like 3 years now. The facility helps me out because I get to come here and take showers so I don't smell and be wearing the same clothes every day. And I think the facility needs money to help us homeless people out, the ones that are considerate of your facility, actually.
I've been looking for apartments, but don't have any luck, so I'm camping out.
They've helped me out by giving me backpacks and clothes and sleeping bags and stuff like that.
Hi, my name is Greg Autry. I've been homeless for a year, and the VA is a place where we can eat, sleep, have fun, hopefully sometimes, and then and the sleeping bag that I will be getting will keep me warm on cold nights. and also used for a pillow as well sometimes.
It is a struggle. It really is. We got to find places to sleep. We sleep at random places like the parks. It's cold out. It's about to get even colder. So blankets and stuff really help us out.
The sleeping bag would keep me warm and out of the cold and keep me nice and warm.
We need donations brought in from whoever can bring us donations as soon as possible.
It's got a place where homeless people can come in and take showers and do laundry and read books, and offers lunch, breakfast for the homeless.
Please help send some money to keep this place open, because it's a good, they help out the homeless really good, and we kind of need help with funds and stuff to keep this shelter running for the homeless. Thank you.
Shane, you got your own place now?
No, I'm staying at a homeless shelter right now.
Uh-huh. But you come here during the day?
Yes.
And you said it helps you with getting on the computer, looking for jobs, and all different kinds of other things?
Yes, it helps with the food. They have like food for like breakfast and lunch, and because I don't have no money and everything, and it helps me to have something in my stomach. So.
Yes, and it helps so many people, all because of those of you that are sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center. New Life Evangelistic Center receives no city, state, or federal dollars, doesn't receive United Way dollars, doesn't apply for such because it wants to take you directly to those in need and don't need the middleman, and doesn't want to jump through the hoops of all the government saying that, well, you can help these people, you can't help those people, you can't have this shelter open, you can't have that. We just want to go directly to people and respond in the way that Jesus told us to do. Been doing it now. It'll be 44 years in January, because there are many, many people that are in need. And sometimes when you try to get the government help or the government agencies, you have to jump through more red tape than you get help, it seems like.
Yes, it is. It's tremendous help. I mean, if it wasn't for this place, I mean, I would have been on the streets or in jail or 6 feet under, you know.
Well, you're saving lives as you get involved at the New Life Evangelistic Center. Springfield, Missouri, at the Veterans Coming Home Center. You can share your special gift at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. So many people getting help.
Hi there. I'm here with John Lawson. John, you're a homeless veteran. You served in the military. You're a senior citizen. You've been homeless for how long?
Almost a year now.
Can you give our viewers an idea of how a veteran of your stature becomes homeless?
Well, I had an apartment, and it's a nice, clean apartment. And the city come by and found a little small patch of mold growing on the side of the building down the far end from my apartment. My apartment was perfectly clean, vacuumed it every day, never had a dirty dish in the sink. And because they found that, they kicked us all out. That we had to leave that night. The only thing I was allowed to take was what I had in my, I could put in my backpack and my bicycle. And they suckered the landlord into coming over there, and they arrested him and took him to jail. But we all had to move. And the elderly lady next door, she didn't have no place to go to get a motel room or anything. So I had $65 and I gave it to her. You know, I told her that you can catch a bus and go out and get your motel room for tonight. She lost all her stuff too. You know, I lost my TV, you know, everything, my bed, nice comfortable bed, nice couch. And I've been basically homeless ever since. I've been having a hard time finding an apartment. But what my little brother, Kenny, just told me, that there's one open there where he lives, and I'm going to go up and talk to the man up there. He said it's just a little bitty, like one room and a shower. That's all I need. I don't need a big place. So hopefully at first of the month, when I get my check, I can go up there and talk to him and rent it and get off the street.
Well, we're praying that that happens for you. In the meantime, we'd sure like to know how a man that's served his country is homeless. That's just shocking to me. But what I want to do is I want to go ahead and give you a sleeping bag, so in case that falls through, you'll still have something. Okay, buddy?
It's going to get down to 45, and I'm going to need it. And I really, really appreciate all the things you've done for me here. You know, you've helped me out quite a bit. You know, you personally have.
It's an honor to help you, brother. It's an honor to know you, okay?
Yeah, I've been going to church. I can't go down them steps and back up, afraid I'll fall. Mm-hmm. But I've been starting to go back to church at that Southside mm-hmm. Baptist Church. Mm-hmm. And I was taken over there on Sundays. And it's real good. The pastor, he's passing away. He's got some terminal disease.
Sorry to hear that.
But he's taking it well, and they're looking for a new pastor. But it's good. They welcome me right in. You know, they come and pick me up here every Sunday morning and take me to church. I've been trying to do that to better myself.
That's good. You know. I'm glad to hear that.
Yeah.
Are you feeling better?
Yeah. Yeah, I am.
That's the main thing.
Yeah, I'm feeling quite a bit better.
I'm not sure if people realize it or not, but the most important thing to the Reverend is that people get closer to God.
Yeah, that's a good church over there. Nice, friendly people. And after the church service, then they have Bible study. And they got Bibles. If you don't have one, they'll give you one. And there's a bunch of really nice people there at that church. They're all very, very friendly. And like some of the happiest times in my life was growing up, going to church. Mm-hmm. You know, and I miss that.
Mm-hmm. I do. I understand that. That was some of the happiest times in my life too.
Yeah, we used to go to other churches. We had this banner. Whoever had the most people show up got a different inscription deal on your banner. We had ours full. Because I had a car, my brother had a car, and my dad had a big station wagon, and pastor had a big Suburban. We just piled all the kids in, and we'd outnumber everybody, and go from church to church to church all around little towns around here. That was a lot of fun.
Sounds like it.
Yeah.
Well, God bless you, brother.
Yeah.
Brittany, you without a home right now?
Yeah.
How important is this place, Brittany?
Very important.
Mm-hmm. I understand you've got a bad cold right now.
I don't know if it's cold. I'm about to go to the hospital.
Wow. But if you weren't able to come in here, you'd just be out on the street somewhere?
Yeah.
Brittany's not alone. There are so many homeless people. Coming to our Veterans Coming Home Center here, Brittany, what kind of help do you get here?
You get to take showers, you get food, you get clothes washed, you get clothes, care items like some medicine. Mm-hmm.
Well, I want to encourage everybody to please pray for Brittany. It's hard being on the streets, isn't it, Brittany?
Yeah, really.
Where did you sleep last night?
In a tent.
Huh?
In a tent.
In a tent somewhere outside?
Yeah.
Well, Brittany, talk to Joe here if you'd like to see about getting into our transitional housing program, okay, Brittany?
All right.
And to help you to break this cycle of homelessness, okay?
All right.
We got a 30-day program, a 90-day program, a 2-year leadership program, okay, Brittany?
Oh, really? Yeah.
Yeah, it's hard to be out on the street, particularly for a woman.
Yeah.
Well, we're in Springfield, Missouri, and we want to see people set free from the cycle of homelessness, and it's happening because of those of you that are caring and sharing with the New Life Evangelistic Center. What a big difference you're making for good. Please get involved and share your much-needed gift now with New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. You're helping so many people be set free from the cycle of homelessness.
Hi, my name is Cynthia Franz, and I've been homeless now this time since July. I had a place for a long time, but things came up and I moved. This place has been very good for me. I need a sleeping bag because it's going to get 40 degrees tonight and I need to be warm when I'm sleeping. I sleep outside. There's a few of us that get together, which is safe. I appreciate everything that I've that's been done for me here. I've gotten clothing. They help out with food, prayer. They help out with people come in from churches and feed us meals, which is really good. The breakfasts are wonderful. Also, it's a nice place to go during the daytime. And when the weather gets bad, it's going to really be warm to come in here and have this place open. So if you could donate, you know, just a little bit of money to help, it would be greatly appreciated by me and everybody else that comes in here that has nowhere to go. I'm on Social Security Disability, and I'm having a really hard time with finding rent and deposit at the same time because the income is very low. It's almost minimal. It's only $753, and it's hard to get an apartment at that amount of money. And there's a lot of people in here that are in here for the same reason I'm in here. So if you could just find it in your heart to you know, help us, the Lord will bless you tenfold.
Hello, we're here in Springfield, Missouri at the Veterans Coming Home Center with Leanna. Leanna, can you give our viewers an idea of how you became homeless and how you found out about the Veterans Coming Home Center, please?
Well, I found out because of my friend Kevin. He told me that you guys helped him out a lot and started off with his, you know, helping feed him and everything. And he told me about all how to get new clothes and everything with your little free store, everything you have. And told me that you guys helped him with the shower and everything. And I also, because when I became homeless, I was taking care of my great-grandfather before he passed away at 104. And then I became homeless, and I was abused by my ex-fiance, who's now going to go to jail. Well, he is in jail right now, but he'll be going to prison, and I have a new life now. But I appreciate everything you guys have ever done, and that's how I became homeless, is being mistreated and always taking care of everybody else but myself. And, you know, I appreciate everything you guys have ever done. And I think that you guys are wonderful people. And God bless you for everything you've ever done. And I appreciate it.
Well, thank you. That's awful sweet. How's the sleeping bag going to help you?
It'll help my back because I have metal in my body, and it's so I won't have to sleep on the concrete.
Well, God bless you.
God bless you guys.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
My name is Carl Ebinger. I am currently homeless, staying at the Victory Mission Men's Shelter. I have been for approximately a month. I have 30 to 90 days until they start charging me rent. I'm a disabled individual. I come to the Veterans Coming Home Center frequently, where they feed me and provide me with warm clothing, support, as far as talking to people, some nice folks that have been donating items, provided cosmetics, toothpaste, toothbrush, some warm socks, and thermal underwear. I have some resources as far as perhaps providing some canned goods and some sundry items to the Veterans Center to contribute, to try to give back and pay it forward. I'm concerned the winter's coming on, and I want to be prepared as far as warm clothing and a sleeping bag in a case of a worst case scenario. I end up actually out from under the roof of that facility and on the street. I would like a warm sleeping bag that these good people here at the Veterans Coming Home Center are providing. I'm going to do my best to elicit individuals. I've been applying for many, many jobs, put in 5 job applications yesterday, trying to get bus passes because, like I said, I am disabled and in between checks, so money's an issue. Trying the local resources to get bus passes so I can put in job applications. I'm leaving from here. I just got an email from Chipotle, a Mexican restaurant, that they're interested in my filling out an application and doing an interview to perhaps get a part-time job there. I can only work part-time because there's a ceiling. My being disabled, I can only make so much money. So I want to stay within that window or underneath that ceiling so I don't disrupt my monthly stipend.
In Springfield, Missouri, it's 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, Missouri, at the New Life Evangelistic Center, Veterans Coming Home Center, and those of you supporting the work of New Life Evangelistic Center are helping so many people throughout the Springfield, Marshfield, Joplin area. What a blessing you are. Tell everyone your name.
James Williams.
James, how's this place helping you here in Springfield, 806 North Jefferson?
It's helping me.
Is it really?
It's helping. It's keeping me warm.
Is it really?
Mm-hmm.
And now, without the place, you'd be out in the street somewhere?
I'm on the streets now.
But, I mean, you'd have to sit out there all day long.
Oh, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And anytime you want to help the homeless and you want to do what God's told you to do, you can rest assured you're going to find a big battle with the powers that be. We had to battle for this place, a former Social Security building in Springfield. And we had the school district didn't want around. The city didn't want around. The county didn't want around. But thank you, Jesus. We prevailed by the grace of God. And hundreds of homeless people every week are helped here, aren't they?
Yes, sir.
So many coming in here. Day after day after day in Springfield, Missouri.
Yep, sure.
Lots and lots of homeless people. All of them getting help because of all of you that are praying for New Life Evangelistic Center and all of you that are sharing what a big difference for good you're making in the lives of so many people. Joe's been doing quite a few interviews. He's been helping a lot of people around here, hasn't he?
Yes, yes, he has.
Chester and the rest of them?
Yep, they sure. They took care of us. All of them did.
And again, it's your donations that help us keep this place open and all the other places for the homeless. It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, the 63166. I'm Larry Rice at 806 North Jefferson at the New Life Evangelistic Center's Veterans Coming Home Center in Springfield, Missouri, where your gifts are helping so many people.
Hi there. I'm here with Lauren at the Veterans Coming Home Center. Lauren, could you give our viewers a little idea of how you became homeless and how you found out about the Veterans Center?
Well, I was helping somebody out along the way and staying with them and paid my rent, and they threw me out on the street and had no money, so I'm kind of stuck in limbo right now. And then somebody told me about the Veterans Center, and I've been here and been here every day, and they've been feeding me well, taking care of me.
Glad to find out that you found out about us, and we're happy to help you. How is the sleeping bag going to help you?
Oh, it's going to keep me warm. It will keep me warm through the winter.
Yep. It's cold out there at night, doesn't it, buddy?
Yeah, very cold. Very cold. I appreciate the sleeping bag.
God bless you, and we hope we can help you more.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hi, my name is Levi Irwin, and I've been homeless for about 4 or 5 years. And the VA has helped me tremendously, and so that I can take a shower every day, get something to eat, get clothes, and I've been needing a sleeping bag to stay warm at night.
Hi there, I'm here with William at the Veterans Coming Home Center. William, can I give our viewers an idea of how you became homeless and how you found out about the Veterans Coming Home Center, please?
I kind of came here giving up a place that used to be a spiritual center that people wanted it back so bad. I finally said, here it is. I found out through One Door and other people about the Veteran Center who have been so kind to me, so gracious to me, and everybody kind of calls me the leader of this batch, and I would give my life for the rest of these people. And those of you out there, don't give up. It is real.
How's this sleeping bag going to help you, William?
Keep me warm.
It's getting cold out, isn't it?
Yes. It's already snowing in the high mountains.
All we want you to do is we want you to stay warm and keep strong. And if there's anything we can do to help you, you let us know, okay?
Please keep contributing to help the VA stay open, to help us.
Hi, I'm here with Tiffany at the Veterans Coming Home Center. Tiffany, can you tell our viewers a little bit about how you became homeless and how you found out about the Veterans Coming Home Center here in Springfield, Missouri?
I've ended up homeless because of my mom. She kicked me out in 2009 after I had my daughter in Arkansas. Then I moved down here in like 2013. I've been at Safe to Sleep for 2.5 years now. I just had a place. I lost it. And the way I found out about the Vets Coming Home Center was through a friend of mine. And she said they help the homeless. And we can do laundry, get clothes, take showers, eat, and everything else.
So it's pretty much been a blessing for you?
Yes.
What would you do if we weren't here?
Live one day at a time.
Be kind of rough out there on the streets if you didn't have this place to come in and get out of the cold and out of the rain, wouldn't it?
Yes.
How's the sleeping bag going to help you?
Keep me warm.
Weather's getting cold out, isn't it?
Very, especially last night.
Well, thank you for sitting down and talking to us, and we hope that you get your place back again, okay?
I'm talking to Betty at this time. And Betty, what does it mean to you to come here to the Veterans Coming Home Center at 806 North Jefferson?
And I like sitting here and talking and visiting with friends.
Do you? So you get, it's an opportunity for the homeless to come together and,
yep,
and visit and fellowship, yep, right?
Yes.
Does it make you feel like, well, you belong? There's people that love you and care about you.
Yes.
It's very important. Fellowship, yep, is. We see how important it is for day centers, for seniors, yep, and for other folks all over. And rich folks got country clubs and others do it. But here's a place for the homeless to get, yep, together and help,
yes,
build you up, right?
Yep.
So don't ever forget how important a place for fellowship, yep, is for the homeless and the hurting. Yep. And do you know that Jesus loves you, Betty?
Yes.
Does he? Yep. Yes, he does, doesn't he?
Yep.
Yes, he does. And he loves you too.
Yes.
And all you wonderful people that are doing what Jesus told you to do in Matthew chapter 25. When I was a stranger, homeless, did you welcome me? When I was naked, did you clothe me? We've got a free store over here, don't,
yes,
we?
Yes.
Jesus told us to do.
Yep.
When I was hungry, did you feed me? They get them fed here, don't,
yes,
they? Yes. And they get to visit and fellowship. And you can partner with New Life Evangelistic Center and be part of this miracle by sharing your much-needed gift now with New Life Evangelistic Center. And that's at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. And know that as you're caring and sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center, you're directly impacting the lives of the hurting and homeless for the glory of God. Oh, you're doing so much good, and it's touching many lives, isn't,
yes,
it?
Yes.
Many, many, many lives.
Yes.
What a blessing you are.
Yes.
So please share your much-needed gift now with the New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166, and know that as you're helping those in need, well, you're just doing what Jesus told all of us to do. Here we are at 806 North Jefferson, one of many places where lives are being touched for the glory of God because of those of you that are caring and sharing.